Welcome to this edition of CMMI Tech Talk, where we will be focusing on quality audits. What is the purpose of a quality audit? Why does ISACA do CMMI quality audits? What can trigger an audit? These are just some of the questions we will be answering in this video. As the name implies, a quality audit is a review of appraisal methods and course offerings that meet ISACA's quality standards. Audits confirm that the person being audited masters the skills expected of ISACA-certified CMMI lead appraisers and instructors. Audits help improve consistency and instill confidence in the CMMI brand. The goal is to help CMMI partners excel and improve CMMI appraisal and course offerings. How are audits identified? What can trigger an audit? Audits may be identified for any of the following reasons: random selection, mentoring purposes, quality, ethics, or compliance reported concerns, patterns or trends indicating quality issues with appraisal or course delivery, understanding, or implementation, conflicting data in appraisal results package or course record submissions, requests for an audit, observation of new CMMI product releases, and/or confirmation that agreements, policies, and guidelines are understood and implemented appropriately. Certified CMMI instructors and certified CMMI lead appraisers will receive an email directly from the CMMI quality team, notifying them of the audit and introducing them to the auditor. CMMI lead appraisers will also receive an automated email from the CMMI appraisal system that the appraisal has been selected for an audit. The appraisal sponsor is a customer of the certified CMMI lead appraisers partner organization. In most cases, it is the certified CMMI lead appraiser's responsibility to notify the appraisal sponsor the appraisal has been identified for an audit. Suppose the audit is being conducted during an active delivery of CMMI services. In that case, the certified CMMI instructor or lead appraiser would inform participants of the audit, including clarifying expectations of the participants and explaining the roles and responsibilities of the auditor during the audit process. The individual selected for audit is evaluated on several things: understanding and interpreting the CMMI model or method definition document accurately, professionalism, delivery of CMMI services in adherence with the ISACA CMMI Code of Professional Conduct, ISACA CMMI policies, MDD, agreements, and guidelines, and appropriate and accurate reporting in ISACA systems. Instructors may be assessed on additional areas, including, but not limited to, use of student-centered teaching techniques, activities, and assessments that support learner objectives, employment of strategies that require students to analyze the relationship between the course learner objectives and solutions relevant to real organizations, development and use of class activities that require students to engage with course materials, content, the instructor, and/or each other, proper application of different formative and summative assessment techniques with a clear purpose, use of tailoring within the ISACA course tailoring guidelines, if applicable, effective planning of course delivery, preparation of course materials, and planning strategies for mitigating risks, and usage of effective instructional strategies in the delivery method and effectively using the platform and/or materials during delivery. Lead appraisers may be assessed on additional areas, including, but not limited to, achieving and managing agreements, decision-making and problem-solving, project planning and management, interpersonal communication and facilitation, integration, articulation, and expression of information, understanding and adapting to organizational context, appraisal method understanding, interpretation, tailoring, adaptation, and application. Your organization is being audited. What are your responsibilities? As an appraisal sponsor, your responsibilities are to be familiar with the requirements outlined in CMMI and assist with the audit. To assist with the audit, you will need to provide information, resources, or access to organizational documents to conduct a valid CMMI audit. Provide a safe environment that allows the auditor to observe any portion of the appraisal delivery. allow the auditor to interact with all appraisal participants or employees who perform the work being appraised, as participants need to feel comfortable being open and honest about their organization without concern for retribution. Validate the appraisal is conducted in accordance with all policies implemented by ISACA and agreements between the CMMI lead appraiser, CMMI partner, and ISACA. Attend any audit meetings or presentations. Maintain appraisal evidence for the duration of the appraisal's validity. And understand that if the appraisal is rescheduled, the audit will also be rescheduled. After an audit is complete, the auditor will create an audit report and submit it to ISACA for review. ISACA will determine and communicate the results to the individual being audited. If any corrective actions are required, an internal review with input from ISACA quality management and internal CMMI SMEs based on the findings of the auditor will be performed. Possible audit results are no action, which means no issues were found. Improvement recommendations, which means some minor issues were noted or some suggestions were identified, but there are no major issues or concerns. Internal ISACA improvement means ISACA may update processes or products based on what was learned through an audit. There may be a gray area in a policy that requires refinement. In some instances where major issues have been identified, a warning letter or recommendation action may be issued. If remediation is required, it could result in additional training requirements, mentoring, coaching, or a written assignment. In some instances where major issues or unethical behaviors have been noted, additional actions may be taken. If a delivery does not meet the quality standards for the relevant product, the appraisal or course will be rejected. A rejected course will result in attendees not receiving credit for that course. A rejected appraisal means ISACA is unwilling to accept the result of that appraisal, and the result will be overturned. An organization may be able to be reappraised at another time. However, if it is determined that an organization misrepresented itself during an appraisal, ISACA may not recognize additional attempts for CMMI appraisal. If the investigation reveals a pattern of serious issues or behaviors, the individual selected for audit is evaluated and their certifications may be revoked. CMMI products and services help organizations thrive in a competitive global market. Standards of excellence apply globally, and the CMMI community is accountable when conducting business in accordance with ISACA's CMMI agreements, policies, processes, requirements, and procedures. Each issue subject to corrective action is evaluated for intent, severity, and number of occurrences. ISACA always wants to help the individual recover and learn from any mistakes. The decision to revoke someone's certification is not made lightly. ISACA would first notify the individual selected for an audit of the results and allow them to relay the information to the appraisal sponsor or students. If the audit negatively impacts the appraisal or course result, and the individual selected for audit fails to notify the organization or students, ISACA will communicate the appraisal or course rejection. Remember, not all audits have negative outcomes. Many appraisals and courses are accepted by ISACA. Thank you for joining me. I hope this CMMI Tech Talk helped shed some light on quality audits. Additional resources on ISACA quality policies can be found using the links below. If you have any questions, please go to support.isaca.org.